Sega.
Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing!
Hey, what's up everyone, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play, this time Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing, as the announcer just said. We're gonna be playing this on the Xbox 360, as you can see. Yes, I finally own an Xbox 360 again, so there's gonna be a whole plethora of games coming to the channel from that in this coming year, with any luck. And you may be wondering, what are we going to be doing in this game? Because if you don't know, I already have a completed save file. In fact, if we go over to my license right here, as you can see, 15 hours, 18 minutes, 35 seconds, a lot of lifetime miles. I have not played this game, in this, like, to this extreme, since like 4 or 5 years ago, before I moved to the US, because that's when I had this game on my Xbox in England. So, as you can see, I've also got all of the achievements. This is one of very few Xbox 360 games where I actually do have them all. In fact, let's go... Wait, where is achievements? There it is. You can tell it's been a little while. As you can see right here, Sonic and Sega Racing, 50 out of 50 achievements. So, yeah, we've got a lot. So, what are we going to be doing? We are going to be heading in to... I'm one page too deep. Okay, we are going to be heading into single player... the Grand Prix. We're going to be doing all of the cups in here, and we're also going to be taking on all of the missions. Now, once we go into Grand Prix, we have our characters. Now, the characters are all unlocked by getting your Sega miles by racing and doing other modes, and then basically purchasing them in the store. So, I have all of them. I'm going to go through them really quick. We, of course, have Sonic. We have II, Billy Hatcher. We have Amigo, Ooh La La, Beat, BD Joe, Zobio and Zobico, we have Rio, we have Jackie and Akira, the Choo Choos, the Bonanza Bros, Alex Kidd, Opa Opa, and in this version, Banjo and Kazooie, because the full title of this game is technically Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing with Banjo Kazooie, because it's the Xbox 360 version. So they're on this. We also have our Xbox avatar, which is obviously exclusive to the Xbox. I believe on the Wii you get access to your Mii, so that's pretty neat. We have Big the Cat, we have Dr. Eggman, we have Shadow the Hedgehog, Knuckles the Echidna, Amy Rose, and Miles Tails Prower, and also Metal Sonic. He's DLC though, you gotta actually pay for him. And there's also an alternate vehicle for Rio over here, however I can't seem to buy it. It's on the Xbox Live store, but I haven't been able to even find it, so I'll try to get it for a later episode, but he has like a forklift that he can use. Anyway, I think for this first episode, we are going to be heading in with Sonic, because of course we are. If we press info, he's... surprisingly, his speed isn't his highest stat, but his turbo boost is. And then it also tells you his all-star move, which is essentially this game's final smash. But we may not get to use it, because it only really shows up if you're like in the really low down places. But maybe we will, maybe I'll screw up a whole bunch. And we're not playing on beginner. Also, why is Billy Hatcher on the beginner thing? He's a badass. He's not a beginner. But we have beginner, advanced, and expert. We're going to be heading in on expert. Now, I'm not too worried about winning every single race. I only care about getting the gold trophy. So, yeah, as you can see right here, we're going to head into the Chow Cup with Seaside Hill, Whale Lagoon, Blizzard Castle, Icicle Valley, Casino Park, Roulette Road, and Carnival Town Sunshine Tour. You're kind of getting a little bit of spoilers for the later ones, but that's okay. I already have the gold, we already got first in it, but for the Let's Play, let's jump into the Chow Cup. And for some reason, the things go up from the bottom, the courses go up from the bottom, I don't really know why, but Seaside Hill, Whale Lagoon is the first one, and I'm going to let the announcer take it away once this loads up. Because I love this announcer.
You've joined us at Seaside Hill, and have we got a race cooking for you today. They call it Seaside Hill, but I can promise you, this circuit is no holiday.
All right, thanks, announcer. And you can also, as you can see right here, choose the music that plays. So I think we're just going to go with the regular Seaside Hill for this. And honestly, in the later levels, I'm just going to let it play whatever the default is. The music is also something that you have to unlock, or you have to pay for using Sega Miles. And one other thing I've got to mention, my Xbox 360 controller, the analog stick on it, sometimes gets stuck going through the left, and it's kind of annoying because this is a racing game, and sometimes you need to go straight, so I'll look into getting a new one, but for the first few episodes of this, it's probably going to be stuck like that, but it's not too bad, it's not really all that noticeable. Like, right now, it's doing it right there, but it's stopped right there. Okay, so, something I really need to mention about this game. You may be thinking, it's a Mario Kart clone. Yes and no. There was kart games before Mario Kart, I know that much. And it takes a Sonic and Sega spin on things. The drift is much different, as you can see. Oh god, rainbow. As you can see, the drift is much different. It's a lot faster paced, I feel, than Mario Kart, because, I mean, it's Sonic, so what did you expect? That's a big old missile. And I am still in third place. We're almost like a lap and a half in, I believe. So, yeah. As for the items, I don't know the official names of all of them, but this is, of course, the speed shoes from the Sonic games that gives you a boost. That is basically your mushroom in this game. That is the triple speed shoes to give you the triple mushrooms. I'm going to be making a lot of Mario Kart comparisons just because I've played so much Mario Kart on this channel. So, yeah. As for the controls, the right trigger is accelerate, left trigger is your drift. And what I really love about this game's drift is you can come out of this one and then immediately go into another one. And you may hear, whenever I'm doing the drift, it does like a little sound. It does like three different little sounds. You can get up to a level 3 tier boost. And it's pretty good. It gives you a huge burst of speed, especially with Sonic, because of course his turbo boost is the highest. As for the other controls, the only one that I really use is A, which is for the items, but also if you don't have an item, which I'll try to show off in just a second, also Big is probably going to beat us, to be honest. If you don't have an item, it's the horn, and whenever you do the horn, you'll do like a little taunt. You see Sonic jump onto the front of his car right there? I think Big is going to win. Oh, Big. Big, let me pass you. No, we put out his little cone. That's basically the banana peel in this game. And then Amy passed us. We got third place. God damn it. Yeah, the X button is also your rear view, so yeah, we could have had that. Look how close we were to Amy. But again, as long as we get the gold overall, I'm not worried about winning every race. I just hope that I can kind of pull that back, because third place on Seaside on the very first level is not ideal, but then again, we're also playing expert, and I really haven't practiced for this playthrough, so I really probably should have done that, but you know what, we'll figure it out as we go. We'll figure it out as we go. Thanks for the advice, Sonic. Pretty sure he already did.
Yeah, it's race day! And we are live from blistering Blizzard Castle! Watch for slippery, frozen tarmac fun here! It's fast, but tricky.
Yep, Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg is making yet another appearance on this channel, and don't you worry. We will most definitely be playing as him at some point. And apparently I got the boost right that time. I think it differs for every character in this game, as opposed to it just being right before 2, like in Mario Kart. And also, shortcut right here, if we go through, there's a crow right there we can boost into. And I believe this is a shortcut. Hope it is. And there's one more mechanic that I've yet to show off in this game, and that is the trick system. But we really haven't gone off of any boosts where I can do it yet, so we'll get to that momentarily. And this right here, this is essentially the super horn before the super horn was the super horn. Oh, here we go. So when you're in the air, hit left trigger, and you will do tricks. You can do, well, you can do as many as you want while you're, like, in the air, but if you land and you haven't finished a trick, you lose the boost that you would get from it. So, did Big just pass me? Where the heck is he? Okay, yeah, there we go, the super horn. There's no blue shell or anything like that, but it basically behaves the exact same. But you can get up to 3 tricks in the air, just like you can get a level 3 boost from the drift, you can get a level 3 trick. So, after you've done 3, if you think you can do a 4th, go nuts, but it's not gonna really do anything for you, damn it. There we go, I can probably get 2 right here. Okay. No, I screwed it up. Okay, so it didn't count as being finished. And Tails has his all-star move back there. That little tornado. And Amy Pastas. And oh my god, I don't think I was ready to play on expert. God damn it, why is everything suddenly screwing with us? Alright, let's just see if we can catch up. We dropped down to 6th? What happened? We're still... Okay, we're in 3rd. Is that shadow right there? Come on, get the level 3 boost. Alright, there we go. Drift another one. There we go. Put up the shield. That is going to be very handy. Because we've been getting hit by everything. I think Amy's way too far ahead for us to be able to catch up with her right now. Which sucks, but not much we can do about it. Okay, 2nd place. Alright, we might be cutting this one a little bit close here. I mean, I know that was only the 2nd race, but we're in 3rd. We're in 3rd overall. Well, at least you're kind of getting the gist of what this game is, right? I love this game, don't get me wrong. I really do love this game. Hence why I managed to get all of the achievements on it. It's just been so long since I've played, and I'm still a little bit rusty, so... Yeah, don't expect me to do phenomenally, but don't worry, if we don't get gold at any point, I will come back through, and we'll grab it later.
Welcome to Casino Park, where the track's guaranteed to be dicey. Don't stop on the roulette wheel, remember the house always wins.
Yep, another Sonic level. Don't get me wrong, I love Sonic the Hedgehog, but there's one too many Sonic levels. Oh, I think I screwed that up again. I did. There's one too many Sonic levels in this game, but I guess I'm not complaining too much. Then again, there's only like... There's like 3 or 4 Billy Hatcher ones. Whereas Sonic gets Seaside Hill-based levels, Casino Park-based levels, and I believe Final Fortress. I don't know why they loved Sonic Heroes so much when making this game, but... I'm not complaining, that's my favorite Sonic game, so... Yeah, here's the very first Casino Park level, and I'm just glad that this stage gets some love, because it's one of the better ones, in my opinion, out of Sonic Heroes. I know a lot of people hate on it because of Bingo Highway, but Bingo Highway is its own thing, and people just kind of always tie it to Casino Park. But, little tip right here, when you're going around these drifts, if you get too close to the edge, which is not happening right now, but... You get too close to the edge, release right trigger like that. I did it wrong, but you can release right trigger. It stops your acceleration a little bit, but you can, it like makes your turn a little bit sharper, so I recommend it if you're gonna go off the side. And what you saw right there with those bombs, you see I had 3 of them. I pressed and held the A button, and it shot out all 3 of them at once. So that's something you can do with the triple items. I think it also works for the speed shoes. But I don't really recommend it for those, but we'll see. Maybe I'll use it at some point. Crunch! Okay, that just went off the cliff. Sure. Is that Tails All-Star right there? Where is Tails himself? I think that was just his All-Star. Oh god, everything is flipped. Everything is flipped. There we go. Alright, I'm gonna try the left path this time. Okay. Alright, we're in 3rd, 4th. Okay, well, we got these homing rockets. The red rockets are essentially... you know, your red shell, because you gotta have a homing item in a kart racing game. Could we, like, stop getting passed by everybody? I don't remember expert- oh, okay. I don't remember expert mode being this... expert? Does that make sense? I don't know. I don't remember them being, I don't remember the CPUs being so aggressive when I played through this previously, but then again, it's been like 4 or 5 years, so maybe they were. Maybe I've been spoiled by Mario Kart CPUs. But then again, they're not exactly forgiving either. in the higher difficulties. Yeah, I think, yeah, Eggman got his all-star right there, but I don't think we're gonna win this. I think Amy has pulled far too far out in front. And, oh my god, we're doing so bad. We are doing so bad, and this is gonna send us off to the side. Ugh. All right, yep. I'll accept my fourth place. God damn. Okay, so I said I didn't practice. I did play the game a bit once I bought it again, but I wasn't this bad. Amy is decimating it. There's no way for us to win now, so I'm gonna have to come back through anyway in an attempt to get the gold, but... Ah, boy. Carnival Town Sunshine Tour. Let's see if we can at least get first place on one race in this Grand Prix. That would be fantastic.
Welcome, race fans, to beautiful Carnival Island. Strap in those eyeballs. We've got a race to run. Is this party a race, or is this race a party? I don't know. Ask me again when they both end.
Ask me again when they both end. I love the announcer in this game. I won't really be commenting on him too much while we're racing, just because I can't really hear him all that well. But he talks about, like, almost everything that's happening. He's got some great lines in this game, so I recommend you you listen out for him whenever we're going through the courses right here. Now, we've had a decent start. I don't want to jinx it, but that wasn't an awful start. We didn't hit into anybody. If we can just... Okay, yeah. You can't fire those backwards for whatever reason. The bombs, they're exclusively forward-thrown items. And Amy, you need to get back here. Luckily, as you can see, it does tell you what item enemies have if they do have them. It, like, floats above their head. But it doesn't really help when Amy just kind of goes in front of you like that and uses it on you. You know, that wasn't great, but... Anyway, I think the thing about this game is because... When I played through it previously, how did that not home in on her? Hi, Big. I would have done beginner, and then I would have done advanced, and then I would have done expert. This time I'm just oh my god, Amy. This time I'm just jumping straight into expert. So, yeah, you know, I kind of learned the lines, like which, what the best lines are, what the best route to take is, where to position yourself on the track, whereas right now I'm just kind of jumping back in and trying to relearn, so... You know. Anyway, no more excuses. We're in first place, which is rare. That hasn't been happening much. I need to keep using my rear view as well, because we can actually see what's incoming behind us. No. Defend myself. I think I might have hit II right there. Or you got hit by one of those green fist things. They are right on our tail. I don't believe this game has two terrible rubber band AI. I think they're just really good. Actually, no. Looking at the map, that's rubber banding right there, indeed. Big is just, like, boosting ahead. Okay, never mind. Ignore what I just said. This game has terrible rubber banding. II, please don't hit me with that. Did he get rid of it? Oh, I think it hit Amy. II is literally right behind me. Could you get... Oh, he's got a bomb, too. Throw it at Big. Go ahead, throw it at Big. II, why are you just holding that bomb? Dude, throw it at Big so I can throw this at someone. He's not gonna do it. No, get Big. Okay, luckily that actually did lock onto Big right there. Has he got three of them? He got three of those freaking bombs, so I can't really pass him yet because he's gonna hit me. But we're gonna pass him anyway because our turbo boost is too good. Don't you dare. Don't you do it. Ugh. I sent that backwards. Did we win? Holy crap, we won a race. We won one. I mean, we didn't win overall. But you know what? That's okay. We managed to get up to second. So, I'll take that. That's the Chow Cup complete. And we got some Sega miles that I don't even need anymore, but, you know, they're gonna add up to onto my total. And apparently they just stop. Yeah, okay, we got the second place. I get it, game. I get it. You don't have to rub it in. And also there's a loading screen with a Sonic Says thing on it every time anything happens. So, get used to that. Anyway, that's going to bring us right back to the title screen. So I'm going to head back in with Sonic again and attempt to get the gold. I won't be showing everything, but here we go. Okay, what I've found is drift at every point you possibly can to get as many boosts as you possibly can. I feel like that's just how you pull ahead. As you see right there, Eggman was right on my tail, and I got a boost around almost every single corner. And also, I got second place on the third race, but I got first on everything else, so... See, I do know what I'm doing. I'm just not that great at doing it. So, look, Eggman actually... several people passed Sonic in the ending cutscene right there. I still don't know why they just stop. That's weird, they just all stop moving. There we go, first place in the Chow Cup. That's all I wanted. Just wanted to see that number one right there, have Sonic standing on the number one podium. Potentially thumbnail material, who knows, we will see. Anyway, it's gonna boot us back to the title screen, of course, and with that, that is gonna be it for this first episode of Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing. Next time, I don't know who we're gonna head in with yet, I haven't quite decided, but we're gonna be going back into expert mode and taking on the Graffiti Cup. So, if you guys enjoyed this very first episode, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.